Daniel, and I'm going to tell you just a little story about the clocks which are made here in the Black Forest, how are they working, and when they started to make them. So, I'll start with the very first generation of clocks, which is this one, and it's made in the year 1640 by two local farmers. As you can see, it has a very simple design because it's entirely made from wood. For the mechanism, it's using only these two, three wooden wheels in the middle, and for the power, it's using only the stone. So whenever the stone is going down, it will move the three wooden wheels and the clock will start working. Unfortunately, it will not show you the accurate time because in the front it has only one hand to show the hours and not the minutes. So you can imagine how hard it was for the people to guess the time at that period. Really hard. That's why the second generation comes 100 years later, which is when the train started to come here in the Black Forest. They wanted to make something special for the railway stations, exactly this clock. That's why the clock also has the design of the old station houses, and if you can see these lines on the sides, which actually represent the railway tracks. But at that time, the people decided to do something else for the decoration, as you can see. Previously, the clocks were only painted on. Now they started to carve the wood for the clocks, and the wood which they're using is called basswood or limewood, which is a very soft and lightweight wood, perfect for carving. But first, they have to leave the wood to dry about 4 years, and only then they can start carving. And to finish a clock, it will take from a couple of days to about a month, depending on the size of it. But just to have the very simple clocks, first we'll start with the casing. After that, we put our decorations in the front, for example, just leaves, and on top we can put a bird with a couple of more leaves. And this way we'll be getting the very simple and traditional design of the Black Forest cuckoo clock. To make them work, they also have developed these metal mechanisms, which are made from brass and stainless steel, and they are actually very well built, so they can last for a very long time, up to 60 to 70 years. But to power them instead of a stone, they started now to use these metal weights. And the clocks which are using the smaller weights are called one day clocks, so they will work exactly 24 hours, and after that you have to rewind them. The others, which are using the bigger ways, are called 8-day clocks. For them, you have to rewind only once in a week. And how to rewind them? It's just by pulling the chains on the clocks like this and keeping the weights all the way up. From about 2 meters height, the weights will go slowly, slowly down until they reach the floor. And that will be the time when you have to pull them back up, you can keep the clock working. But on some of the clocks, you see that instead of having 2 traditional weights, we're going to have 3 weights like on this one. That's because here we'll have the people moving, the water wheel spinning, and also the dancers on top will start rotating. We're also going to have a music box, so we have some nice melodies. But now I'm going to play the clock for you, so you can see what exactly is going to happen. The first thing that you'll notice is this very typical Black Forest scene, the woman holding a rolling pin in her hand and scolding the two gentlemen because they're wasting their time drinking beer instead of making cuckoo clocks. You have to listen more to your wives so you don't get hit on your heads like this. I will keep this away from the women to help you a little. And the most important thing for the cuckoo clocks is actually the cuckoo sound which we are getting from these two wooden air bellows. They are working like whistles, and whenever the air is coming in and out, they'll make the sound like this. And whenever I play them together... Okay. Does it sound like cuckoo?
Yes.
Yes. But also, for the smaller clocks, we'll have smaller air bellows. And it will sound like a baby cuckoo. And of course, for the bigger clocks, we'll have the bigger air bellows. Which sounds like a very old cuckoo. But don't worry, because you can also switch off the sound, especially for the night, so you don't have to kill the clock or something else. The switch is like a lever, so whenever you pull it up in the night, the cuckoo will go to sleep just like you. And only in the morning, if you decide, you can put it back on again, and the cuckoo will be awakened. But, as I said, this is only a small part of the history of the mechanical cuckoo clocks, which are still a big tradition here, but nowadays you can also find battery-powered clocks. They're also going to have the same design and carvings, just like the mechanical ones. The only difference is the mechanism powered by the batteries. They're also going to have very short chains, unlike the mechanical ones, which are having very long, with the weights on them, but they will be only for decoration, so you don't have to pull them. And just to mention that, because here the prices in the shop are all labeled with the taxes included, which you actually don't have to pay, you'll be getting a tax refund card from your tour leader. And with them, if you purchase something above 50 euros, you'll be entitled for a tax refund. So, thank you for your attention, have a good day, and enjoy your time.
ఓకే మీరు ఇక్కడ ఉండండి, నేను తీసుకొచ్చు. సార్ నేను ఇక్కడికి వస్తాను. ఎక్స్క్యూజ్ మీ.
जय मध्य प्रदेश
जिला सबसे बहुत अच्छी है, सबसे
एक मिनट
है.
Thank you.